an experienced campaigner, you would have to say, is joining us on the line. But the older he's getting, the more goals he's scoring. He's the top scorer in the championship. He's going to be the busiest man in Scottish football this weekend, because he also is the head coach of Partick Thistle's women's team, who play in their first ever final against Rangers on Sunday.
And he's got the initials of a well-known band, BG.
Right, okay, I was wondering where you were going. Brian Graham's on the line. How are you, Brian?
I'm good, Gordon. How you doing, panel? All right.
Good.
I don't know. I've given you the big build-up about it being a busy weekend, but I'm conscious
I'm laughing at Hughes with the Bee Gees.
I've put you in the same bracket as Hugh Keevans, is getting better with age, which I do apologise for. You're not quite that old, it has to be said. How are you looking forward to this weekend, Brian? It's going to be quite something for you, isn't it?
To be honest, it's been a really busy week. There's been a lot going on, but it's been really exciting. Obviously, preparations for tomorrow, way to Arbroath, but obviously, the excitement of the cup final on Sunday. So there's been a lot happening, but first and foremost, I need to go and make sure we get 3 points at Arbroath tomorrow, and then quarter to five, 10 to 5 tomorrow, then my mind will shift to the cup final on Sunday.
Is that the way it has to be? Because you're used to this dual role. It's not like it's anything new, but such an important time of the season for the men's team. Could barely be more important, the chance to make history for your women's team. Have you just had to almost do that, where tonight and tomorrow it's about the men's team, and then, you know, almost put it in two different compartments?
Of course you've got to, because first and foremost my full-time job is playing for the men's side. And then a couple of years ago when I took the women's job on, I wasn't really sure how it was going to go, but they've came on leaps and bounds, and back-to-back top six finishes, now found ourselves in a cup final where we've got a real chance of going to win it in my eyes.
Yeah, let's go men's team first then, because the reason you got the Hugh Keevans comparison, the goal scoring isn't slowing down anytime soon. Top scorer in the championship. How are you feeling about the task tomorrow, and I suppose the running, because we're at that really important part of the season, aren't we?
Yeah, listen, scoring goals, I've always scored goals when I played regular, and I've been playing regular for Partick Thistle now for a couple of years, and I've been top goal scorer every year that I've been at the club. So I got 21 last year, I'm on 21 at the moment. A couple of dodgy refereeing decisions, I probably should be on more, but hey-ho. Tomorrow, I'll wait at Arbroath. Listen, I know they're bottom of the league, but you seen Raith Rovers going there a couple of weeks ago and they got beat after being 2-0 up, and they thought they were cruising, but it'll be a difficult afternoon. We've looked at the weather forecast, the wind machine will be on.
Oh, that's right.
So we just need to go up there, make sure we've got a job done, because, listen, we hadn't picked up a win yet for a couple of weeks. It was a hard game against Morton last week where we got a well-deserved 3 points, and we need to go and get another big, massive 3 points to make sure we stay in those playoff places.
How does the mindset shift then, in terms of, because I think most people will kind of see the obvious differences. Tomorrow you can impact things, you can run a wee bit harder, you can jump a bit higher, you can, you know, you can try and score for the men's team, and then very quickly it's more about your preparation for the women's team, and then of course you relinquish control to an extent and stand on the touchline. What's that like to do it, you know, like one day after the other?
It's very difficult, but see, if you've had a bad game on a Saturday, it's a good distraction to have. But obviously, if you've had a good day, you can have a bit of banter with the girls, say, right, I scored yesterday, you need to score today, sort of thing.
Brian, do you buy into that philosophy that I think pressure is a privilege, because you know, you're essential to the men's team and you're essential to the women's team, and to be able to show why over a 48-hour period of time, I think that's a great thing.
Listen, it's hard at times, don't get me wrong, but I really relish both roles. I really enjoy both roles, and I've got a real good changing room with the girls, where it's not just good football players, they're good girls and good people, and that's first and foremost. And then the football comes after that. If you can sort your changing room out nice and early, get the right characters in there, it gives you half a chance.
How important has the man management been then, or you know, the getting that belief and putting the right messages across as part of your preparation? Because you know, I've seen you do some media this week and trying to, you know, get that message out there that your team are there on merit and deserve to be there, because everybody else is going to obviously point out the fact that Rangers are full time and they've got an astronomical budget compared to yours and so on, and there's the underdog nature of it. So how do you strike that balance?
Yeah, listen, we know we're the underdogs, make no illusions of it, but at the same time, it's the word I used when I first took over the club was belief within the group that we can strive to do greatness, and the girls have bought into that, And you've seen that, because the back-to-back top six finishes, it's not easy being a part-time team. There's a lot of other clubs round about us. We did it the first year with 1 point. This year, we've absolutely stormed it. We set out targets at the beginning of the year, and we've been ticking them along as the season's been going on. Now we're in the business end of the season where we're in the top six, where we want to improve on last year's top six performances. And to get the cup final, they deserve huge credit, because everybody in the country expects Rangers to win. Let's not make no mistake about that. But within our group, we believe we can go and win the cup.
You got a cup final suit looked out?
I do. We went, me and Big Ross went out. The club sent us to go and get a couple of suits to do it properly. So the girls gave us plenty of stick for it. So, but plus, and see all these wee touches, that's what cup finals are all about.
Well, exactly. I was going to say, cup final suit. You've even had a cup final song. A local songwriter, Thistle fan, Nathan Beard, did a song for you as well. Is that, are these all the things that make it feel a bit more, a bit more special, a bit more real?
No, it's great, and it's the girls, they're all buying into it as well. They're all buzzing with the song. And obviously Sunday, we're doing everything correct. We're leaving from Fir Hill, we'll go to the hotel, we'll have pre-match, we'll do everything as if it was a full-time environment. So we're trying to make sure we're getting everything right off the pitch. And then once we get on the Tynecastle, Hugh was speaking about responsibility, and once you cross the white line, we can give instructions, but the players need to take responsibility within themselves and believe that they can go and do the job, and as I said, go and be the hero for Partick Thistle.
Brilliant, Brian, we'll let you go because I know you're a busy man. That's an understatement, but all the best at the weekend in both roles.
I really appreciate it. Thank
you. Good luck Brian.
Brilliant, all the best.
Thank you very much. Thank you. All the best. Bye bye.
Cheers. That's Brian Graham leading the line for Thistle Men's, then the head coach of the women on Sunday, without giving too much away because it hasn't obviously broadcast yet. As part of TV Cut, I have spent an extreme amount of time with Brian Graham this week. Oh. And then when I text him today to come on this show, I thought he is going to be sick of me. So fair play to him for coming on and giving us his thoughts. I mean, like a serious amount of time.